Hello YouTube. Welcome to my Marantz cassette deck, model number SD-60. This is a high-end Audiophile cassette deck featuring dual capstans and three heads. Now the dual capstan idea is there is a capstan and a pinch roller on the supply side, which results in an even tension of tape across the heads. So it should be a nice stable playback. Now I won this for £41 from eBay. I was actually standing on my doorstep as it finished in auction and I was very pleased to win it. Dates from around about 1993-94. Also Revox have a similar model. Well, it's the electronics inside are identical. It's the Revox C-115. The only difference being obviously having a Revox branded front panel. And the inputs and outputs on the rear are actually balanced. And it also is in a Philips guise. It's an FC-60. Obviously Marantz is the high-end division of Philips anyway. Now I recently changed the belts in the deck and I've recalibrated it for the metal tapes that I use and for the chrome tapes, but I really wanted a high-end cassette deck mainly to have the bias fine tune, the calibration which actually adjusts the final level that goes onto the tape to bring it up to the same as the input. Also, this machine has HX Pro. Now HX Pro on this model is actually switchable. On most machines it is on all the time. It is only effective in recordings, basically just enhances the top end. It does absolutely nothing in playback, so normally I leave that switched on. The next button, noise reduction on and off, and then the button beside that is which noise reduction, Dolby C or Dolby B. And then you've got an MPX filter which was only useful for those of you who recorded from the FM radio stations, because that filtered out the 19 kilohertz tone. Obviously your tape transport controls here, record, mute, source and tape. Now you've got this all blank skip, so if you've got a long blank portion in the cassette, you press that and that will fast forward the blank and then find the next program on the tape. Automatic music search will automatically search for each track, play about 10 seconds of each track unless you actually hit the play button and it will just play. And you've got the quick music search which again searches for the gaps in between tracks and continues playing. Then you've got the counter controls. Also this one is great because it actually has a real-time counter as well. Now without further ado, I'm going to use my trusty Philips C-650 as the input source. Connect the outputs to my computer and let's hear the sound of this machine. I'll switch it back to source to begin with. Hit record on the computer.